Yes, good morning YouTube. So this is looking at the wiring diagram for this Advantium SpeedCook oven. This is the 120 volt 60 hertz model. And you can see here's your main power cord. You have your live or line connection here, goes through a 20 amp fuse that's inside the unit. And then right here is this cavity TCO that I mentioned in the previous video. And so I wanted to talk about that a little bit, and one of the reasons, or some of the reasons, I think it's not properly designed, and the reason why I bypassed mine for now. So that's where it is, and you can see the entire power for the oven goes through the fuse, goes through that cavity TCO, and you can see everything has relays. There's a relay there, a relay there, relay, relay. There's bunches. There's 4, 6, 9, there's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 relays. I think this cavity TCO should have also been run through a relay as well. We already have 15 relays. Why not add one for this? And let me show you why I think that. Okay, so this is the official GE part number. Came from geappliances.com. I'll show you where you can get these a little bit cheaper. Through GE, they're $25 to $30. I think I paid about $15 when I bought these some years back. But that's the official part. There it is. You can see it's pretty tiny, and they are expecting to shove approximately 15 amps through this thing. The oven, when it's running, is pulling 1600 to 1700 watts. It's the only thing I've plugged into my P3 kilowatt meter that made the meter beep, because it was an overload. 120 volts, 15 amps is 1800 watts, and I was measuring 1600 to 1700. So that's probably 13 to 14 amps running through that. So let's see what that reads for resistance. Let me clip on to the probe here. So my probes are 0.06 ohms. So 60 milliohms. Let's check the device. It's pretty sensitive to your connection. So let's say roughly 1.2 ohms. Just for sake of argument here, let's try a second meter just to get a second reading. So it says it's a resistor, 0.09 ohms. These are kind of finer wires. And then let's clip on to the TCO thermal cutout, and we'll retest. It says it's a resistor, 1.34. So that's pretty similar to the other meter. So let's look at that on the screen again. Okay, so we'll take the lower of the two readings. So we had 1.2 ohms on the meter, and then minus 0.06, that says that thermal cutout is 1.14 ohms. The voltage across that's going to be the current times the resistance, so let's say 13 amps. So that's 15 volts drop across that thermal cutout out of 120, and then if you take volts times amps, 237 watts are dissipated across that little thing. 237 watts when this thing is running. I don't think so. And that is not right. So yeah, if you go on to eBay and you search for this generic part number, this KSD1-150, and you can see these all show up under that listing. Here's one for $8, $10, here's a $6 one, two for $10. So they're quite a bit cheaper if you buy this generic part number rather than the GE part number, which is the GE number is 21X10046. So this is the official GE number. Look at that. $24. That's the exact part I have right there. $24. If you enter KDS1 space 150, it's $5. Same exact part. I'm replacing a thermal cutout fuse with a fuse. And it's in series with another fuse, so there's already a fuse there. And yeah, that part is just not designed to handle 15 amps. I don't know what GE was thinking when they put that in there. But if anybody has any information on that part, please post it up in the comment section below. I'd love to find a manufacturer data sheet or something to see what the recommended application is. Use your own judgment on what you want to do with that. I've been running with a fuse in there for quite a few years now. When the TCO overheated, it damaged the wires here on either side of the TCO, and so I replaced the TCO, and then ultimately I replaced the wire terminals. And between both of those, now the fuse doesn't overheat, the wires don't overheat, and everything's happy. And the stove doesn't cut out in the middle of cooking dinner or breakfast or whatever meal you're cooking, because that's very inconvenient. Anyway, I thought I'd pass that on, show you what my reasoning for what I did. Definitely get a hold of this service manual. It is very helpful, and you can find out all sorts of things about how this oven works. It's actually quite a nice oven. Just has this main problem here. That's the one weak point of the whole thing, and I've just bypassed mine. You can do with yours as you please. Not giving any advice, just saying this works for me. If you're not comfortable with that, you can maybe consult an appliance technician and they can advise you what to do. So anyway, just thought I'd pass that on. If anyone has any ideas about that, post up in the comments section below. As always, thanks for watching. See ya!